Hey friends, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Ashley, and today's video is going to be jam-packed with tons of cleaning, of course, plus some organizing. I really needed to label my containers in my pantry and just get tons of different areas in this house tidied up again because it was just starting to pile up and it was driving me crazy. So if you're in need of some cleaning motivation, you're definitely in the right place. First, I'm starting off in my bedroom. I just had tons of stuff piling up on my dresser. The floors were messy. I really needed to vacuum in here. So we're gonna tackle my bedroom first thing because it's definitely an area that I will put off and forget about if I don't do it right away. Since I don't really go into my bedroom that often, let me know if you guys feel the same way, but I don't go in here unless it's either nighttime or, you know, if I'm getting ready for the day. Other than that, I'm not really in my bedroom, so whatever mess is in there, I can sometimes forget and neglect. So, first things first, we're getting this cleaned up. I gotta pick up my clothes. I'm so behind on laundry, you guys. There's definitely gonna be some laundry motivation in today's video because the laundry is so bad.
Don't scare you too much, babe. I wish to flatter, not alienate. Since I met you, my life's like a train.
So you guys will notice I have a lot of things accumulating on my dresser. I am in the middle of getting a new desk and organizing my workspace, and I also bought a lot of new cleaning products and equipment and stuff, and the random things are just kind of sitting on my dresser because I haven't used them yet. If you guys saw, I have a new steamer. I bought a handheld steamer so I could try it on my clothes that are wrinkled, and I will definitely let you guys know what I think about it. I'm gonna review it for you guys. So that's why I just have a lot of stuff on my dresser right now. I feel like my life is getting a bit cluttered. So I need to get it together, but I'm super excited to finally be getting, you know, just my workspace organized. I'm getting, you know, things labeled in today's video. So I'm excited. I love decluttering and organizing. It's probably one of my favorite things to do because you just feel so much better after you get done organizing a space and decluttering it. So make sure, if you are new here and you're not subscribed, make sure you hit that subscribe button if you enjoy decluttering and organizing motivation, because I upload tons of those videos all the time. And with Christmas right around the corner, that is definitely something that is on my to-do list. But now it's time to organize all of these containers, which brings us to today's video sponsor, Supvan. So huge thank you to them. They gifted me this super cute label maker. It comes in a few different colors. I love this pink. It is so cute. And what's great about this is that the machine uses inkless thermal technology, so you can enjoy 25% higher clarity without relying on printer ink and toner, so you can print with ease and not have to worry about running out of ink. They also offer a smart app where you can control everything at the touch of your finger. You guys, it was so easy to use and maneuver. They had so many cute different frames to pick from, and they also have over 600 templates, which include fonts, text, graphics, symbols, icons, and so much more. You can customize your label any way you like. And what's also great about it is you can create continuous labels and make them really long, or they also offer fixed size labels. And my favorite feature by far is how easy it is to cut your label when you're done. You simply lift up on the tip and it cuts it perfectly. You don't have to worry about it being crooked or anything. I love how easy this is to use, and it's easy to remove the backing because it's actually split down the middle, so you can lift up the top and the bottom and reveal the sticky side of it, which makes it so much easier because, you guys, trying to peel the edges off of labels is so tedious. So it is definitely the little things that make this such an amazing label maker, especially how these labels are also waterproof. So make sure you guys check out SupVan. I will have their link down in my description for you guys. I know you would love this product and it'll make labeling so much easier for you. But once again, thank you so much, SupVan, for sponsoring today's video. I needed to do some rearranging because I had some extras of like chocolate chips and stuff that I really wanted to try to fit into my containers. So we're gonna be swapping things around a little bit and making sure I label them correctly. I have one bin that has like my stevia in it, and I have been meaning to label it for quite some time because I'm like, I don't want someone to come in here, like if my husband's cooking or something, and reaches for what he thinks is like powdered sugar and it's actually stevia. So I definitely needed to get my containers labeled. They look so nice. And what's great about these is they come off pretty easy as well. They don't leave any stickiness behind because I did have to remove one when I mislabeled it. So if I need to swap the labels around in the future, it really won't be that big of a deal. I really do try to clean the containers if I'm like swapping items in and out of them, not only, you know, for sanitary reasons, but also it really makes your containers look really clear and crisp and clean. Because, you know, sometimes if you just swap things around, after a while your jars start to look a bit dusty. So if you notice your containers are looking not so crisp and clean, maybe it's time to take the things out of them, give them a good cleaning, and then put the items back inside of them just to get them nice and cleaned up again. Cause I've always been told that things will unfold if you keep on waiting. But then you came along and proved me all wrong. I was so mistaken. Cause you glue all the pieces. In case y'all are wondering where I got these containers from, I purchased majority of them from Sam's Club. It came in a really big bundle and it was at a good price. So I'll be sure to link them down below, especially with the holidays coming up. They usually go on sale. So I picked up majority of them from Sam's, and then I got some other ones from Walmart, which I will go ahead and link to in case you guys are looking for some. I love both of these. It's working great at keeping my food fresh for whenever I use it next. And I love that the lids are so easy to use. You just lift them up and then it comes right off. And then when you're ready to seal it, you just press the lid down and it seals right back up again. Cause I finally learned my lesson. Cause you glue all the pieces back together. Yeah, you take all my wrongs and make them better. Yeah, you're making me. Now that those are nice and organized again, I put them back into the pantry, and now we're heading into the laundry room. You guys, I was not lying when I said that my laundry was so bad. I have so much clothes, and this isn't even all of them. Our clothes in our bedroom were overflowing. Like, I really needed to grab more clothes out of our closet, but I was gonna tackle this before getting any more because it gets super overwhelming having all the laundry in the laundry room. But we're gonna get some done. We're gonna get some folding done. I actually have two loads that need to be folded, so we're gonna tackle that. And you guys already know I'm still using the same Downy beads in the Ocean Mist scent. By far my favorite. I love it. And one of y'all recommended I see the it's the same like light Downy beads, but it's a green top. I want to say it's like forest something. I did smell them at Walmart, and you guys, that one smells so good too. I haven't tried it on my laundry quite yet, but I have to say that one smells really good as well. I'm thinking about picking some up soon just so I can give it a try, but I'm really loving these Downy light beads. For a light scent, they sure do leave your laundry smelling so good. And y'all know I don't really use any fabric sheets in the dryer anymore. I'm trying to get better on, you know, not using as much chemicals in my laundry. It's so hard because I just love my laundry to smell good. That's just my preference. I know it's not that great for you, but I don't know. I'm just obsessed with my laundry smelling good. But now that I've taken away the fabric sheets, at least I'm helping a little. I use the wool balls in the dryer. They work great at getting the static out and stuff. And those downy beads are so strong that I'm able to dry my clothes and still have like a really good scent when I pull them out. As before, you know, sometimes the different beads I would use, or if I just use a liquid softener, I would have to use fabric sheets to have like a strong scent on my clothes. But I noticed that with the downy beads, I don't have to do that. So if you guys are kind of hesitant on like spending the extra money on beads, I definitely say it's worth it, because then you could just skip the, you know, buying the sheets. That'll save you some money, and just put the money towards your beads, because I just think the beads work great at making your clothes smell so good. As I was picking up the laundry, look what I found. Ethan stuck my little decor plant ball pieces into the outlet. Oh my gosh. I cannot believe he did that. He is not one to like mess with the outlets or play with them. So when I saw that, I was like, oh my gosh. So I had to have a very stern conversation with him explaining how dangerous that is. Thank goodness it was something like plastic and nothing metal. I just could not believe he did that. But my husband was like, don't mess with it. He's going to turn off the power and remove the little balls out of there, because yeah. Oh my gosh. I just cannot believe he did that. Like, kids, man, I'm sure if you have a toddler, you're not surprised, because kids do the darnest things. But as you can see, we're picking up the laundry that I just got done folding, and then we're going to be heading upstairs to pick up my boys' clothes. But before I got started putting away their clothes, I needed to clean up their room because it was looking a bit messy in here. The kids have been playing a lot more upstairs ever since I brought the big bin of toys from downstairs upstairs. If you guys watched my last video, I went ahead and made that change, and they've been playing upstairs a lot more. It's been helping a lot with keeping downstairs tidier, so I'm very thankful for that. The only downside is that Austin, my 7-year-old, his chore is that he has to pick up downstairs, like all the toys, the trash, laundry, whatever might be on the floor at the end of the day. He cleans it up. And every time now, he's like, Mom, you need to put a laundry basket, or not a laundry, a toy basket down here. I don't want to bring him upstairs. But I'm just like, nope, sorry about your luck. Here's a laundry basket. Put it in there. Carry all the stuff upstairs. But besides that, it's been working out really good. Downstairs has been much more tidier these days. And I am planning on doing a little makeover in my formal dining room since I moved the big table out of there, which I am super excited about. I told you guys I'm getting a desk, so I cannot wait to get that space all fixed up and ready for my desk. And I actually am thinking this year, if you guys are new, last year I put our Christmas tree in our dining room nook near the kitchen. Just because the tree is so tall, I can't remember, I want to say it's like a 9-foot tree, 10-foot tree, something like that, but it actually was touching the ceiling, and it was so big that I couldn't fit it in our living room. Like, we just didn't have any space, so I had to move our table that was in the dining room nook out of the way to put our tree. So I told my husband, since I just moved that big table into our dining room nook, I was like, I do not want to have to move that again. That was a pain in the butt. So I think we're actually going to put our tree in our formal dining room. and just have it over there. So I'll likely leave, you know, plenty of space in there, just put my desk in there for now, and then maybe do something after the holidays are over with like organization or something. I don't know, but I'm just super excited to have a space for me to work and store all of my like paperwork and calendars and just all of the things. So I'm really excited. I was planning on doing some more deeper cleaning in the boys' bedroom, but Ethan was actually begging to take a nap, so I was like, you know what, that's fine. At least I got the bare minimum done. I made him wait so I could vacuum. I was like, give me just a couple minutes. Let me just vacuum in here, and then I'll lay you down. But y'all, that was all of the sippy cups that was in the boys' room. Like, they have a problem with cups. Like, between Ethan, of course, he's my three-year-old. Of course, he has sippy cups. But then Austin, my seven-year-old, he likes to bring them to bed with him because he doesn't like to get up and have to like put his water on his TV stand. He wants it in his bed. And I've given him such a hard time about all of the water bottles that he's using reusable ones. But instead of using the same one, he gets a new one every night. So now we have a huge collection of water bottles. But whatever, at least he's not using the plastic ones anymore, which makes me happy because he was doing a lot of wasting of water. But now we're heading into our little game room area-ish. It's kind of just a storage area for right now. We need to get this space cleaned up, but I have my cat litter box over here. That's the little, you know, fake looking plant in the corner. I needed to clean the litter box, so I did that really quick. And then every time I clean the litter box, I always vacuum because there's cat litter everywhere. So we're gonna vacuum in here, get it all cleaned up. As I was vacuuming, I noticed how dusty and dirty the rail was right here. Last week, I vacuumed the stairs and like did the railings along the steps, but I completely forgot about the railing up here. So I was like, you know what? Let's go ahead and get it cleaned up. So I'm using my Method wood cleaner to wipe it down. My cat actually loves hanging out right there. He loves to look over the balcony. So I'm pretty sure it was so dusty and dirty right there because that's one of his favorite hangout spots. Now I'm heading into the kids' bathroom, which is upstairs. This is the main bathroom the kids use, and it's always messy. You guys, surprisingly today, it really wasn't as bad as it usually is, but it really needed some attention. I needed to clean up all of the trash. I still haven't ordered a bigger trash can. I need to get on that. I keep meaning to order one off of Amazon. So I need to do that, but we're gonna get it cleaned up in here. And I really wanted to wipe down the cabinets because it had been a while. I like to wipe them down probably once a month or so, just because the kids and their toothpaste, which as you can see, I went to go pick up the blue thing off of the floor. I thought it was trash. No, it was a huge gob of toothpaste and I stuck my finger right in it. So I had to get that cleaned up, but we're just gonna get the bathroom back in order. And the toilet really was starting to smell like urine. So, you know, I have three boys in the house. So it was time for me to give the toilet a really good deep cleaning as well, just to get that stink out of the bathroom.
Come closer, dance for me. Easy tiger, easy, let your hair down. Come closer, let me see all your million faces and all your million mistakes. You don't to hide. Come closer so that we can be together. Everything that has been don't matter no more. We've burned it. All those whirlwinds can't touch us no more.
I've really been loving the Sprayway all-purpose cleaner. The stuff works so good and I'm loving the smell of it as well. Y'all know I'm a huge scent person. I only want to clean with stuff and use products that, I don't know, just smell good and leave me feeling happy when I get done, because cleaning really is therapeutic for me. Let me know if you guys feel the same, but there's just something about cleaning and when you get done, like all the scents that are left behind, it really puts me in such a good mood. Even if I'm having like a rough day or, you know, the kids have me all wound up, I find that cleaning really calms me down, and especially having a really good cleaning product that I love using. Let me know if y'all feel the same way or maybe I'm just weird, but it really is therapeutic to me. I wanted to share my newest audiobook with you guys that I've been listening to because I have been loving it. It's called Manifesting: How to Manifest Your Desires and Use Habits to Become a Super Attractor of Money, Success, and Happiness. It is written by Stephen Bernstein and Gabrielle Covey. And you guys, I have been loving this book so much. It's so just like uplifting and it really helps you just look at the bright side in life. Sometimes I feel like we dwell on the negative things and often forget how much positivity and how much good we have in our lives to be thankful for. So I've really been loving it. It's been opening up my eyes and just making me realize, you know, there's so much to be thankful for, so don't dwell on the little things in life. But if you guys are into the law of attraction and stuff like that, you should definitely check out that book. It's a really good one. Like I said, I'm just listening to it on the audiobook because that's all I have time for. Busy mom life. I never get to sit down and read these days. Maybe one day, but not today. But this is going to be the end of all of the cleaning motivation. I did go ahead and put a grocery haul in today's video. You guys said you enjoyed them, so that's gonna be next. Make sure you subscribe if you're not yet. I wanted to quickly show you guys my grocery haul for the week. I do have HelloFresh meals, so I really didn't need too much. This is just to make a couple meals and lunch ideas, so I'll quickly show you guys what I picked up. So I got some of this imitation crab meat. I do plan on making sushi this week. I love making homemade sushi and haven't done it in a while. So I like to pick up the imitation crab. And then I also got a cucumber. That way I can put cucumber inside of it as well as some avocado. And then me and Adrian love drinking kefir. It has tons of probiotics in there. So we like to get that in. I also needed a bell pepper for one of my recipes, so I picked up one of those, and some ginger. I usually get fresh ginger,
but I typically don't use that much and then it goes to waste. So I was like, you know what? I'm gonna go ahead, give the minced ginger a try, see what I think about it. And then I picked up 2 packs of these organic pitted medjool dates. I love eating these for a healthy snack. I put peanut butter and a couple dark chocolate chips in it. And you guys, they're seriously so good. They taste like healthy Snickers. If you haven't tried it, definitely try it out. It's so good. We were running low on fruit, so I picked up some bananas to snack on, 2 mangoes. These are my favorite. I love these little yellow mangoes. Also needed some corn for a recipe, so I got 2 bags of frozen corn. And then I also needed broccoli, so I got 2 bags of the frozen broccoli. And then of course I needed the nori to make the sushi. And I was excited to see they now offer organic nori. I don't believe they have this before, so I'm excited it's organic. I also needed some shrimp for a recipe. I'm gonna be doing like this broccoli and shrimp stir fry looking stuff. And you put ginger in there and it just looks so good. So I'm excited to give that recipe a try. I'm also making a new recipe using cabbage and ground beef. And it just looks really good. It's supposed to be like a casserole and I've never tried cabbage in like a casserole. So excited to give that recipe a try. And then I also got some strawberries and some blackberries. I didn't want to go too crazy with the fresh produce because we are going out of town this weekend. So I just want to make sure that we're going to eat everything produce wise and nothing will go to waste. So that is everything that I picked up. I spent a total of $55, I believe. So not too bad.